Nowadays, nearly every smart industrial device with Ethernet port or wireless connection has a web server for settings, diagnostics, control, or God knows what else developers may put inside their product. Would be nice to have it available on operator level, right? What if I tell you it is possible with CP600 HMI panel? Want to know how? Then let's start the episode. There are two ways we can set up a web browser on a HMI panel. First is useful when you need to combine standard HMI functionality like graphs, buttons, alarms, etc. together with a web browser functionality. So we head to widget gallery, then media, then web control section, grab web browser widget and place it on a page. Resize it to your liking, maybe leave some space for the title, add a label and adjust it however you like. Change size, location, adjust it to the center and so on. Next, it's a good idea to set a homepage. So when the panel starts, it would display this page. And since we're talking about panels here, why not to open a web page dedicated to them? Last part is actually a very important one. Web browser plugin, technically it's a Qt library web engine, if someone is curious. By default is not loaded to a panel to save space. So we need to go to Project Properties, find section Plugin, and then enable Browser Plugin. We will get this warning window which says that panel runtime is modified and we need to reinstall it. With empty panel, just load the project and install runtime. Panel with already installed runtime might require forced runtime update. Now we just need to download project to the panel. It will usually take around 2 minutes together with runtime installation. After panel installation is done for the first time, we explicitly command to start HMI runtime. And then panel displays desired web page. As I previously mentioned, this approach is useful when you want to view a web page in existing HMI project. As you can expect, it takes some toll on the device performance. In case you need just a web browser functionality, let's say you already have web visualization inside PLC and want to display just that, then the approach would be different. First, we would need to download Chromium web browser package. We can find it on our web page. Scroll down to the download section, select category software, and find Chromium package for PSP 1.3, which is the newest version now when this video is being recorded. Download the package. Now that we have the Chromium package ready, there are two ways to install it into the panel. First one is through the panel system settings web interface. We head to a web browser again, type panel's IP address / /machine_config and hit enter. At this step we must enter admin login and password. And we have panel system settings interface in front of us. To install package we go to applications, hit app management button, then install update button. In a pop-up window, click Browse Image and select the package file we have just downloaded. Click Proceed and wait till the panel completes installation. When the process is finished, we hit Back and then Restart. For the second way to install a Chromium package, we would need a USB memory stick. Then copy downloaded package file to the root folder of the memory stick and plug the memory stick into any USB port of the panel. And now, to install the package on the panel, we go to Startup Sequence, enter your admin credentials, press Install button in the bottom left corner of the screen. Now we need to find the package file. As it usually done in Linux systems, external drives are being mounted into MNT directory. USB stick is mounted as a USB memory device, and inside it, we'll find our Chromium installation package. So we select the file and tap OK button. Panel will install Chromium browser into the system. Once it is finished, we will see Chromium application in both installed apps and in boot sequence section, which means that this application will start next time the panel is powered on. We're done with this part, and let's start the app. From this point, browser installation and setup process will look the same regardless the way you choose to install it. On the first start, we need to enter admin credentials again to get to the browser settings. First thing which browser will need from us to work is a country code. In my case, United States English has already been selected. You might need to select the language you want the web pages to be displayed in. Now we need to restart panel again. And I know you're already tired of these passwords, but for the last time, enter admin login and password. This time on the left panel, we have dedicated the web browser section in which, if we tap edit in the top right corner, we can adjust various settings of the application, like homepage. Let's use the same control panel's web page on the global ABB website. We would like to enable toolbar because it will make our life easier afterwards. Maybe loading controls will be useful. Other things are pretty much optional. So we save our settings, restart the panel again to main OS. This time we have load homepage button by tapping which panel will display configured web page. And voila, we have our web page loaded. We can even scroll down to the download section we've seen before. That wasn't so hard, was it? Thanks for watching. Keep automating with us. Have a lovely day.